So far, we have the ability to edit contacts in our application. In this lesson, we will change the contact detail screen to allow creating new contacts. Let me just quickly go over what we want to do with this lesson. The first thing that we want to change here in the contact detail is actually the title of the page, because when we want to create a new contact, we cannot show here the name of the contact. It doesn't exist yet. So we want to show here a different title depending on if we are creating or editing a contact. The same is to say that when my contact ID is empty, and the contact ID here, remember that it's this input parameter on the page. So when this input parameter is empty, and we'll see how we're going to test for this. When this is empty, in that case, true here, I want to show here on the screen new contact. And when it's not empty, so when we pass a value, for instance, when this contact ID equals 1 or 2 and so on, I want to show here the name of the contact, and this will be, for instance, Joanna Rivera. Okay, so that's the first change we're going to do here on the screen, is to change the title. Next, we will need to check how we're going to fetch the information from the database in the preparation action. Remember that we have an aggregate that gets this ID, goes into the database to find the contact there, so that it then shows here in the form the information about this contact. We will need to check if we need to do anything here in the preparation for this to still work. And the final thing we'll need to do is actually to look into the save action, because when we are editing a contact, so in this case here, when we are showing Joanna Rivera, we are actually going to send with the update contact, we're going to send the changes in Joanna Rivera, for instance, the change in the name or in the phone number, we're going to send those changes back to the database to be stored. When we are creating a contact, we can't use the update contact action. We will need to use the create contact action for that matter. Okay, so this is generally what we're going to do. Let me just clean up here the drawing so that we can get these things done. Okay, so let's start by setting the title of the page, and to set the title according to that condition that we saw here, the contact ID being empty, we're going to use this tool here. This is the UIIF, and the UIIF allows you to show or hide parts of the user interface based on a condition that will evaluate to true or false. So let's add the if here to the screen, and you'll see that the if has a true part, which is the top part of the if, and it has a false part. What you will also notice is that the if tool has a condition, and this is where we're going to write down that condition that we had here. So the contact ID, our input parameter, needs to be empty. Since the contact ID is a contact identifier, what we're going to do here is actually to match this contact ID to test if this value is equal to null identifier. And this null identifier, this is a built-in function that returns an empty value for an identifier. So this is a special value for you to compare with the input parameter to test if the input parameter is null or is empty. So what we said is that when our contact ID is empty, then we are going to show here in the true part, we're going to show new contact. When it's not empty, we want to show the name of the contact. So we already have here this expression with the name of the contact. I'm just going to drag and drop it inside the false part of the if. And that's it for the title. So we're done here. Now, let's go into the preparation. And remember that we have here, we have an aggregate that filters the contacts using the contact ID. What will happen is when this contact ID is null, when this contact ID is empty, then we will have no contacts returned from the database. Because let me just show you here. The ID actually has a value. In this case, Joanna is ID number one. We don't have in the database any contact with an empty identifier because this is a primary key attribute. This attribute needs to be filled in. So this means that when we try to get a contact with an ID equals to null, then from the database we will get no contacts. And this means that on the form here on the screen, we will have an empty form for us to create a new contact. So that's why we don't need to change anything here in the preparation in this aggregate. We only need now to take care of the save action so that we can create or update the contact that we have on the screen. So let's go into the save action here. And basically what I'm going to do is to use the counterpart for the logic of the UI if, which is this if tool here. And let me just rearrange here the notes. And when this is, let me just put here the condition, as you expect, it also has a condition. When our contact ID is null, so the same condition we added to the screen, when this is null, then we want to do something here, which is actually to create the contact. When it is false, then we want to update it. And you will notice that here in the data tab, on the contact entity, we actually have a create contact entity action, which we're going to use in this situation here. And just like the update action, the create action receives a record as a source parameter, and this will be the record of the form. Okay, so when our contact is null, then we will create the contact. When it's not null, then we are going to update it. Now, this is one way of doing this logic, but actually, there is a simpler way of doing this, because if you'll notice here, in the contact entity, we have a create or update contact entity action. And basically, this action, let me just get some space here in the flow, this action that I'm going to add to the flow now does all this logic that we have here for you in one shot. So basically, what you need to provide to this action, like you did for the update and the create contact actions, you'll need to provide the source record, which we will get it from the form, that one. And what it does is when the contact doesn't exist in the database, then it will create the contact. It will insert that contact in the database. When the contact already exists in the database, then it will update that contact. Okay, so we can remove all this logic here. Right click and delete these nodes. And this is a simple way of doing all that logic. One final thing we need to do to be able to create contacts, we need to go back into the contact screen and add a new link here to create a contact. So new contact, and we're going to link this text to the contact detail. And now we need to fill in the input parameter. And probably you already guessed that here we are going to actually pass the null identifier value. This is the value that we are testing in the logic that we change in the contact detail. So when this contact ID has this value, the screen will behave as creating a new contact. The title will be new contact, and the create or update action will actually insert that contact in the database. So we're done here. Let's publish and create a contact. Okay, so here we have, let's try to create a new contact for our phone book, and let's call him John Doe and put here a phone number, and let's save it, and let's see, and there we have it, John Doe, the last contact in our list. And that's it.